I hope you guys are doing well. So, SGRIs are a great way to light up the scene. For those people who like photorealism, it's actually very easy for them to, you know, get SGRIs. But for those of us who, you know, like NPR style, non-photorealistic renders, then we don't get SGRIs for free, or actually anywhere at all. I actually have checked around, and I actually only find 4 SGRIs online, but then I managed to create my own NPR SGRIs by using these techniques. So there are actually 2 methods that we're going to discuss today. The first one is going to be converting a regular SGRI into an NPR SGRI, and the other one is going to be changing almost any type of image into an SGRI. So for this one, the first method, we're going to be needing an SGRI from sgrihaven.com. It's completely free. I suggest you I'll actually leave a link to this in the description below. And I suggest you choose a high contrast one, because those seem to work better for me. And you can do a lot, use the other ones. It's, all of these, the first and the second process I'm going to show you, requires a lot of experimentation. So it is dependent a lot on how you want to do things. So I've chosen this high school driving one. You can choose any size you want. Remember, the bigger the size, the more time it will take to change it. So yeah, that's that. And the next thing we're going to be using is another free program, GIMP. So GIMP is like basically a free Photoshop version, a free version of Photoshop. Okay, a legal free version of Photoshop. So you can download and install it. It's pretty simple. So once you have installed it, we're going to be opening the SGRI in GIMP. So right click, open with, and GU image manipulation program, or you can just choose another if it is invisible over here, and then you can use it. So then when it opens up in GIMP, you can see it's actually realistic. I'll just zoom in. You see everything is realistic. So I'm going to be using filters, and the filter usually works better for clouds. So I actually just wanted the cloudy part of it, this SGRI, so it will work for me and that well. You can use other types, like I said, a lot of experimentation is required for this one. So I'm going to click qualify. This filter works really well for clouds, and I'm going to change this to 77, and I'm going to click OK. And once it is done, I'll show you how it changes. So in about a second, you are going to see it change from realistic to non-realistic. Now you can see the clouds also changed. So yeah, this is pretty much ready to be used, and now we're going to go into Blender to actually use it. I'm just going to close it now for now. To actually save this, go to File, Export As, and you have to add the extension .sgr and all export file images. This should be it. The name can be anything obviously, but you can add .sgr. You have to add .sgr to save it as an SGR file, and this should be all export file images, and then click export to export it. So yeah, I don't need it anymore, so I'm going to close this one now. And you can go to Blender, and this is the same SGR I showed you, and as you can see, this actually works pretty well. The lighting is working pretty perfectly. In material mode, you can see there are no lightings used by me. So this was the first method. You can actually use the SGR by going to show director and changing these to world, and then use an environment texture, add in the environment by this, and use mapping node and texture coordinate. You will be using these two because we are kind of faking it, so that's why. So the second method is actually really better. You can change almost any kind of image, almost any kind of image into an SGRI. So using that, so I'm going to I'm going to leave a link to this one in the description below if you want to use this one. The second method will require us to change this image into an SGRI type of image. This is sort of a workaround, but it definitely gives a lot better result than the other one. You can download this image, it's completely free as well. Use the large original size. I don't recommend using medium or small. So download this. And for this one, I'm going to be using Inkscape again. My second last tutorial thing had this one. So Inkscape can be used for a lot of SVG file stuff, graphic designing, etc. So I would recommend checking it out. So once installed, downloaded and installed both of the software, they are handy for a lot of other works. You need to use a lot of other softwares to get desired results in Blender as well. Even professionals use, I think, minimum of 3 types of software, like one for sound, one for this 2D version softwares, and one for 3D modeling, so and stuff, you know, like Blender. So once Once the image is downloaded and Inkscape is installed, go to Inkscape, File, Import. I already have the image downloaded, so I'm going to open it over here. So the first thing obviously is we are going to apply filter on it as well. Again, I'm going to use the oil paint one. So image paints, oil painting. And you can see now it's also NPR style. So I'm going to copy this, paste it here, and then click on this to flip it. Remember, flipping is the important part. And now you can, as I move it around, you can see it's already starting to click. So I think you might be understanding what I'm about to do. So click on Control and then move it to about here. As these two images are now completely merged, you can even tell them apart. Now shift click to click both of them. Okay, both of the images should be selected. Object, object group. Okay, now they are grouped, but we're still not done with this one because this extra space is going to be problematic. So we don't want that. Deselect it, click on this rectangular tool, click over here, and move it to about this part. Okay. So it should be covering the base part of the HR, and then click on Control Shift to move this about here, and then just shift to move this part here. We should be covering a little bit inward of the HRI. So don't click on anything. This should be selected. For the next part, just do exactly as I say. While having this rectangle selected, click here. Now it's under the HRI. Oh, HR image. Now it's still selected. The lowest rectangle is still selected. So right click it and click on duplicate. Now the outer rectangle is selected. Keep it selected and then select everything else like this. Now click on object, clip, set. Now you have this image. Okay. So now you have to export it. File, export PNG image. You can change the location wherever you want and then click on here to export, and then this will finally export it. Okay, so once we have exported it, we'll be needing to go to Blender now. Okay, so first we're going to add this as an SGI. So going to shader editor, I'm going to remove this and change this back to 0 and open up this SGI. Okay, so when I rendered mode, you can see we're getting this beautiful lights from these clouds. So everything seems okay. As you can see, there is no ditch, there is no weird connection of etc. But the problem is with this method. This, even though this produces really beautiful results and can be used on almost any kind of image, the flaw is over here, the downward part and the upward part. The downward part can easily be avoided. This basically most of what we're going to be doing, we actually add in a plane and set in the ground, so that can avoid. But you have to kind of avoid the upper part, okay, so to actually make it work. But you actually have a lot of flexibility with this one still, and which there is another thing you can add to make it even better. So you need to have the images plane add-on enabled. It's a built-in add-on. Go to edit preferences, images plane add-on should be activated for this one. And shift A, images plane, navigate to wherever you actually saved it and click on image. By default it's going to be unprincipled, but you have to click on image and then import images plane. Okay, now it's imported. Now we have the material with this as well, and now we don't need it, so I'm going to delete it. Shift A, mesh, cylinder, scale it, like make it really big, shade smooth, tab and go into edit mode, go into face select mode, click on this upper and lower faces and delete them, and then give them the HRI material, whatever the name of the images was. It's going to be coming here as a material. So now when I hit rendered, you can see that we're getting it a lot better results because of this. Okay, the upper fly is still there, but for some reason being global, it's actually giving this a better result. But there's still one more thing that I need to do. So going to solid mode, I'm going to flip the view, While having cylinder selected, go into the UV editor and tab to go into edit mode, select everything. It wasn't selecting the lower part, so I'm going to B box select the lower part and then G Y to move them downward. For some reason it doesn't work like that. And now we're going to go into the 3D viewport. And now, as you can see, you're getting the lights from the environmental HDRI. The lighting is coming from the environment, and this is going giving you the better result. You can basically use almost any kind of camera angles, but you have to avoid the upper part, obviously. But this is still a really great workaround to getting NPR results. And for example, the images you have to use, the images cannot have this sort of thing, you know, this which shaded area is actually going to be moving like this, forming a circle. These images are really harder to edit, so it will be difficult for you. I'm not saying you cannot completely use it, but you can, but it will be a lot more harder. And secondly, the moon is also a problem. For example, when we mirror it, what we did was flip the image, mirror it, and then use it. The moons will be used twice. Okay, you can't have two moons unless it's a fancy scene or something, but you can easily edit them by using GIMP. For example, in this image, it doesn't have that weird circle area, so you can edit the moon out by using GIMP. I think I should just show you, so to make it easier for you. So this is, I think, the moon image. I'll just show you how to easily edit it. We can simply use the paintbrush tool. Okay, click over here, add in, if you use the color picker to change, click on the environment around it, and then you can simply, you know, paint over it to hide it. Okay, you can also use the smart brush heal tool or the stamp tool for this purposes. Obviously, it depends upon the image you have, and you know, so it is image editing for a bit, so you'll have the result like this. You know, you can barely can even tell anything, and the original image is still there, so you can just simply export these two and open them up in Inkscape, apply the filter, and then combine them the same way I told you before. So I hope you guys learned something today. Please leave a like, subscribe to our channel. Comment on the video, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.